I wanna touch your booty all night long.
Hey girl.
I wanna touch your booty.
It's me.
All night long.
If that booty's sitting alone tonight.
I wanna touch your booty.
Bring it over here.
All night long.
And let me touch it.
I wanna touch your booty.
Yeah, girl.
All night long.
Put it right there, girl.
I wanna touch your booty.
See, it all started with the rasher.
What is that?
I think it's raining blood.
Ow! Stop it!
You little fucker!
Stop it!
Be careful of the rain, Squirt!
Whatever.
I will destroy you. Just one joint, man.
My name is Beast.
He's the Antichrist, Dad.
He's the Antichrist. He's the Antichrist.
He's not as bad as everybody says.
Oh, come on! Not Orlando!
Would you describe the comedy in this film as beast cock or baby chicken penis?
I'm going for beast cock, easily.
Think, yeah, if there's a choice between baby chicken penis and beast cock, you gotta eat beast cock.
A little of both. I mean, I usually do a lot of beast cock, chicken pants types of things.
Yeah.
So more like, I mean, some say like chicken cock, which I don't think it's that.
You have some baby chicken penis moments, but it's devoured by the beast cock.
I think there's value to baby chicken because that's all the tickle, and then beast cock is the pickle, right?
Mm-hmm.
So there's a value in both ends. It's not like an obvious beast
cock.
Well,
yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's made up, beast cock is made up of baby chicken penis, right? So it's, you got both.
So we're good?
Yes and no. Yes and no. I mostly like my movies sans cock.
Now it's time for romance.
Would you say that not being raptured is the equivalent of sitting on the devil's dick?
That's a great question.
Well, let's hope that that's not the case. That seems painful.
I want to be raptured. I want to go.
See, when you do these junkets, that's the one that everybody asks. Is not being raptured like sitting on the devil's dick? And no, I would say that it is like wanting to be, at least my character, to be sitting on the devil's dick and just never quite getting there, right?
What? I want to go up there and be like, I'm home, yeah. Woo! Welcome home to heaven, yeah, yeah.
Welcome home to heaven, yeah, yeah. Welcome home to heaven, welcome home to heaven, welcome home to heaven, yeah, yeah.
Good times.
We talk about the mention of the vagina-flavored ice cream. And I wanted to kind of get your take on what you would think those ingredients would be.
Vaginal ice cream has long been an idea of mine for a shop. So it's, I'm a little put off that you said that. I feel like
you're treading on
copyrighted territory.
I don't want to trade the business. I just want to talk about whether that's what you guys fall as far as flavor.
Vagina flavored ice cream would, of course, be, I mean, sugar and cream would be the main ingredients. The other ingredients, I mean, frankly, it's gonna be like chemicals. You know what I mean? It's gonna be made in a plant in New Jersey somewhere, like, and you're not gonna be able to pronounce it, and you put them all together and it tastes like vagina. So, I don't know, man. Like, I don't know what those guys do. I don't know how they do their thing.
Now, this film, it was pistachio and mint, and I was like, I don't know how many women would be happy with that.
There was like two really good flavors that that go great together.
But the vagina, I don't know.
Well, I mean, let's get one thing straight. I love pussy.
My pussy's so wet.
What about your restaurant chain, Dick Shaped Foods?
Dick Shaped Foods is up and running in Cleveland, and we are going
What kind of people eat at Dick Shaped Foods?
Well, it's for, you know, whoever likes Dick Shaped Foods, what can I say? You know, you just gotta go in and enjoy it.
Hot dogs, corn on the cob, popsicles,
sausages. We had like 12 cases of sausages.
Yeah. Really, yeah, anything.
Yeah. Lollipops, shaped like.
Yeah.
Anything dicks. Shaped like a dick.
Yeah,
that's
good. And sometimes we mold, like you can make dick shaped cornbread, you know, stuff
that
naturally.
You can bake or make anything.
Yeah, you can bake it into
that shape.
A dick shape.
And don't forget the balls!
Now, when you're getting ready to have sex with the beast, there's a lot of preparation one must do. And I wanted to kind of get a sense of what's most important to you guys between trimming the bush, bleaching the asshole, and just general douching.
They all serve a specific purpose.
I mean, I don't understand the whole bleaching the asshole phenomenon. I just really like to just go natural. Trimming the bush. God, I mean, that's the age-old question, and it has to do with the times.
And it looks great, as always.
And what was the other one? Painting toenails?
Painting toenails.
Hey, come on, that's disgusting.
That's gross.
You really crossed a line with that.
Trim your bush.
Bleach your asshole. Whatever you gotta do.
Bleach your asshole. Whatever you gotta do.
I am suffering.
Now, were you guys surprised to find out that the recipe for saving the world, which was roofies, weed, and a dog cage, is also the recipe for a great orgy?
No, not surprised at all.
That makes sense.
You know what I like is that people sort of see what they want to see in a movie. And some would say a comedy biblical romp, but you see orgies. And you know what? If that's what you take away from it, like, the answer is yes.
Not surprised at all. I've had several dog cage roofies orgies, weed orgy parties.
Yeah.
Fantastic. You can't. And then
what could go wrong? What could go wrong?
Throwing some dick shaped food and vaginal ice cream flavor.
Oh, you got
forget about
birthday
it.
Party right there. Yeah.
Hello.
Fuck you.
Ah! Is it okay if I drink coffee? I don't want to ruin your interview.
No, we can.
I don't want to sully this interview.
Now, when you're in a game of shit talking with a foul mouthed crow,
I feel like I am right now.
It feels that way, and I think I'm going to say, is the coup de grace move using the word felch?
No.
It can be talked. You think it
can
be talked?
Felching. Nobody felches anymore.
They accuse people of felching.
Who gets accused of felching?
Felching. He doesn't know what that means.
I want everybody to understand that this is a family movie, and there is no the crow say a lot. There is no actual felching in this film.
It's just a
description. That was in the talking points that I read today. Like, there's going to be a lot of questions about felching. Make it clear, because we're going for the, 8 to 10-year-old audience.
What is that?
It's coming right at us.
Ben, wait!
You barbecued my son.
I panicked. I laser beamed him. I beamed Jesus. I'm so sorry.
Go see this motherfucking movie, y'all!
Rapturepalooza is, cunting fuck dick. Motherfucker.
You piece of shit. You fucking go see this movie, unless you want to get your ass kicked.
Wow.
Not by me, but by him.
Hot.
You piece of shit.
I wanna touch your booty all night long. I wanna touch that booty all night long.
Bring that booty over here.
Mountain high.
I will climb a rope for that booty.
Booty.
Oh, you're getting closer.
You're
pulling back.
Booty.
Who's your daddy?